Currently in the United States, about two-thirds of all Americans are clinically overweight, and about a third of all Americans are so far into that category they're actually clinically obese. People are hoping for some kind of magic bullet, something that they can just take, and in a few seconds, you know, they can lose weight, ideally without changing their diet or their exercise. And so that is this market for over-the-counter weight loss drugs. So what makes this market really interesting is it's almost completely unregulated because over-the-counter weight loss pills are regulated like a food item. The problem is that these pills basically don't work and they can kill you. The area of health behaviors I think is fascinating from the point of view of an economist is because although most people, when they hear the word economics or economist, they think of, you know, interest rates or inflation or deficits, these kind of aggregate numbers that don't seem to have much relevance for your everyday life. But that's really a very misleading idea of what economics is all about, because economics is a social science. It's the study of how people behave and why people make the decisions they do. And I'm particularly interested in the decisions people make regarding risky behaviors. My name is John Cawley. I'm an economist in the Department of Policy Analysis and Management at the College of Human Ecology at Cornell University. And my research focus is the economics of obesity. And that covers both the economic causes of obesity, like income and advertising, the economic consequences of obesity, like wage discrimination or job absenteeism, and also treatments for obesity, like the use of financial rewards for weight loss.